second half, or do you think that with an extra man you should be winning?
I believe that with extra man we should win this game because we had one player more, I think 30-35 minutes, yes? And I believe that first 10-15 minutes when we play 11 against 11 in the second half, it was much better and we were the team who were dominant. If you speak about first 45 minutes, must be realistic and say that Brentford, it was the team who were dominant, had controlled the game. Few good chances, two good chances. We had maybe one with the Sarr from the beginning, and maybe they deserve something more from these 45 minutes, first 45 minutes. But in the second 45 minutes, I believe that we started good. We were the team who did a good defense, the good pressing, good passing in this first 10-15 minutes, and we score one goal. After the penalty, we stay with one player more. But again, it's not first time that we concede a goal immediately after when we score. It's not first game. Okay, don't understand why it's happened, and we spoke about that a lot of times. And you know, especially when you have one player more, it's not something usually. But again, you know, it's the game. We need to continue. It's we cannot be satisfied with 1 point because of everything what's happened. And during the game, and I speak about when we stay with one player more, that means we try to change the situation, to put two strikers extra inside, to use more our wing player, fullback, for the crossing. But we played totally opposite in the last 15-20 minutes. We try to play with the long ball from behind with two central defender of them, which it's totally crazy. But again, I believe that you know why. What is the reason? We need to find the reason, and we need to fix this problem what we had.
What about penalties? Do you think?
Listen, from my view, I believe that it was the boat, okay, from the bench, because I believe that our player, our Ismaïla Sarr, it was the guy who get advantage. And he move the ball in front of the opposite opponent, and he's push him from behind, and he go to score. I mean, it's not a question. If I have seen good from my position, okay, I believe it's happened. I didn't see from the TV something. I didn't watch again, but I believe that it's happened something like that. And we had the same situation, a similar situation against Brentford, if you remember here. You know, but it was just play. Okay, and against Brentford, against Bournemouth. I mean about Bournemouth, it was a similar situation, yes? But, and about the hand of Cabasele, from my view, I believe that the ball touched him in his hand. I cannot speak now because I didn't see the video, but I get one picture from one of my friends who sent me about the goal of Stipe Peric. It was clear goal. It was clear goal. It's no question about it. And I believe that they cancel us one clear goal. But again, want to believe that it's happened. It is the game. The mistakes happen. That means we need to continue. We need to work. To first of all recognize our problem in our game. What we had in the first 45 minutes and in the last 20-25 minutes with one player more. Because you know the football is this that we need to. To fix the problem from the previous games to don't happen in the next.
Was it for it to his boss given offside? Because he looked to be level, the goal was disallowed. Was it him that was offside?
I cannot speak from my view from the bench because I didn't know. I believe that it was offside.
Yeah.
Okay. But after when I come back in the dressing room, I see exactly the moment of the cross and the position of the striker and of the defensive player. It was clear. It's not question about the situation because I believe that it was clear goal. No chance that it was offside.
Okay. Does that frustrate you?
You know, it's for sure I'm frustrated. You know, everybody is frustrated with something like that happen. You know, because this is this happened because we don't have war. You know, we can speak now about one game when cleverly score and they said that the ball don't cross the line. No, this is the football, you know, this happened. Because of that, I believe that VAR is good to have in the championship because this is some small details which make the big difference. If we had today VAR, I believe that we could take two points more. Or maybe in the, some previous game, maybe we can stay without some points. But again, I believe that VAR is good because of this situation, what's happened today, and maybe in some previous games.
At the end of the game, as you were going off, you had a discussion with your opposite number today, Thomas Frank. It was, you got there in the end.
Guys, listen, it's not first time. It's not happened first time. For me, it's a big surprise here because, you know, first time see something like that, not just in this game, in the previous games, you know, because we have the fourth referee, 4-1. And when my colleague from the opposite side, the other coach, speak with referee, he can speak with him whatever he wants. It's his right. Yes, I cannot complain for this, what he will speak with him. He can do whatever he wants. I believe the same me. When I speak with the referee, cannot speak for me, I don't know what. I don't want to speak now the verbs, what he used.
Yeah.
Okay? Because, but not just in the bench, you know? And it's happened until now, I think, 10 times. We play 90 games 10 times. It's totally crazy. If he want to speak with, not he, everyone, speak with the 4-1, speak with him. It's, you're right, you can do whatever you want. Yes?
Yeah.
The same me. But if I speak with him, you cannot complain, you cannot speak against me something.
Yeah.
Yes?
Yeah.
I think it's fair enough. It's totally, totally correct.
Yeah.
Yes? Okay, after he's apologized after, but okay, it's, you know. It's
it got heated. But it got there in the end. I just wanted to ask you about when you were in Birmingham, you named two goalkeepers on the bench.
Yes.
Why were there two goalkeepers on the bench this time around? Was there not another? It's not a big issue, but
no, but we didn't have another player to put.
Really?
Yes. it's like this. How I said, we didn't have other player to put
so
because we had some guys from under 23, but they play today the game,
right.
And for me it's better that these players play the game than sitting with us and don't play. You know, because. About Quina, yes, he got injured yesterday during the practice and he stayed out because of that, not because we didn't take him with us because of some reason. You know.
And Pedro is injured as well.
And Pedro is still injured. We're waiting to get information about his injury.
Click here to subscribe.